Cyclone Battered Cardwell is tonight isolated. All roads in and out of the town are cut by floodwaters. Homes and businesses that were spared by Cyclone Yasi have now been flooded and the town could be cut off for days.
Cardwell residents are used to disasters, but not so close to each other. The town's underwater, just a month after Cyclone Yasi tore the place apart.
No, we don't need this. Only thing now we need is an earthquake, and we've had a trifecta then.
Locals say they haven't seen flooding like this in 40 years. In 24 hours, they've had more than 200 millimetres of rain.
How much more are they going to dish to us?
Businesses and homes spared by Yasi couldn't escape this time. All the rebuilding that was so desperately needed has been put on hold, with street after street going under.
We've been frantically pumping and carrying on, but we're losing.
The town could be isolated for days.
So we're stuck north, we're stuck south. Nothing's coming in. I know the bread supply this morning is completely sold out at the supermarket, so we're out of bread again.
We are concerned about cars being washed off causeways, and we do caution people to stay out of this water. It is rapidly moving water.
Further south, a woman and her four children had to be rescued as floodwaters threatened their Townsville home.
Horrible. Absolutely horrible. Very scary.
A woman suffering a respiratory condition was plucked from her home by swiftwater rescuers as water engulfed her property. Near Cairns, police recovered the body of a Karanda woman swept away in floods.
I think the thoughts of all Queenslanders are with them.
Nicholas Boot, 10 News.